good evening, and welcome to our midweek Lenten service. We will be continuing the theme that we looked at on Sunday. We are called to listen. As our service continues, please continue to check in on Facebook. Let us know you're there. Just say, I'm here, I'm watching, I'm with you. Like the video so we know you are watching with us and worshiping tonight. So as we learned on Sunday, sometimes it's the noise that's all around us that distracts us and gets in our way of hearing God's voice. We need to remove our headphones to be able to listen. Our headphones that contain the noise of the world. We remove those to listen for God's voice, to be able to hear what God is telling us. So tonight, I want you to find a comfortable spot wherever you are. If you're on your couch, if you're in your chair, if you're listening as you're walking, wherever you are, be comfortable where you are and take a few deep breaths as you get settled for our service. Let go of whatever took place today. If you are seated, place your feet on the ground and tune out the rest of the noises that you may hear around you. Put down your phone if you're watching on a computer or TV. Turn off the TV if you're watching on your computer. Let those distractions fade away. Just concentrate on what's being said tonight. The words to the songs. And be able to feel their impact on you. As our theme reminds us again and again, we are called to listen. This is part of our invitation as people of faith to not only speak and pray and sing, but to listen. And we struggle to listen, particularly when we don't know what we're listening for, or those times when we don't agree with what we're actually hearing. So for just a moment, as we gather ourselves for worship, I want to invite you to join me in embodying a prayer as I prompt you. So let us listen and let us pray. I invite you to close your eyes. Rest your feet on the floor beneath you. Release any tension you are holding in your jaw, in your neck, in your shoulders, in your hands, down into your feet. Take a deep breath in and slowly let it out. We know the Hebrew word for breath is the same word for spirit. So as you continue to breathe in, imagine that it is God who is filling up your lungs with energy, with love. Trust that God is as close as your very breath. Now I invite you to still your mind. imagine your mind as a river. Thoughts will drift into view, they always do. However, instead of holding on to those thoughts, allow yourself to let them float by. And listen. Listen deep. Listen far. Listen wide. Listen. And as we are practicing our listening tonight, let's begin with a poem from a sanctified art artist, Sarah R. You can keep your eyes closed. Just take a moment to just listen. Truth that ricochets. I went to a lecture once. An interfaith conversation with interfaith leaders. Whispers bounced off the church's tile floors as people shuffled into place, carrying hope alongside assumptions, mixed into pockets like loose change. About halfway through the evening, a young woman in a blue hijab began speaking. She was the youngest person on the panel, seated far to the left. You might almost miss her if you weren't paying attention. But not here. Not when she spoke. In quiet determination, she told us of fear and persecution. She told us of hatred and racial slurs thrown at her people from car windows like bombs. It was a truth I did not know. And that truth ricocheted like sunlight through the cathedral windows, touching almost everyone that day. Then a man in the back who could have been me, who has been me, approached the microphone and said, "Your people are persecuted. You live in fear. You are battered by hate. If that is true, then why am I just now hearing of it? Why is your story not on the news? Why have you not spoken up about it?" And the air was still, partly because we held our breath in anticipation, and partly because the Spirit slows her dance and we stand at the edge. The woman in the blue hijab leaned into the microphone and whispered with a quiet strength that can only come from years of practice, "We are screaming." If there is one truth in my life that unfolds again and again, it is the need to listen. For again and again, I will try with good intentions to act and walk with love. But again and again, I will make mistakes. Again and again, I will say the wrong thing. Again and again, they will call me Peter. And again, they will be right. So again and again, I will pray for a truth that ricochets, for ears that will listen, and for space to hold truth if people are screaming? And to be clear, people are screaming. I do not want to miss it. Let us now listen to this song. I want to read to you tonight a piece of scripture from the 8th chapter of Mark. Then an angel of the Lord said to Philip, "Get up and go toward the south to the road that goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza. This is a wilderness road." So he got up and went. Now there was an Ethiopian eunuch, a court official of Candace, the queen of the Ethiopians, in charge of her entire treasury. He had come to Jerusalem to worship and was returning home. Seated in his chariot, he was reading the prophet Isaiah. Then the Spirit said to Philip, "Go over to this chariot and join it." So Philip ran up to it and heard him reading the prophet Isaiah. He asked, "Do you understand what you are reading?" He replied, "How can I, unless someone guides me?" And he invited Philip to get in and sit beside him. As I said Sunday, listening can be hard. It is an art form, just like painting, that needs to be practiced in order to perfect. In this Bible story, we see Philip listening to the call of the Holy Spirit, who tells him to go. Doesn't question, he goes. And we see Philip listen again as the Spirit calls him to join this man, this Ethiopian, in his chariot. These two men then have a conversation about the scriptures in which they take turns listening to each other. There was no agenda, only open ears and hearts. This two-way communication became a way of opening up the scriptures, allowing the Ethiopian to understand, and in turn, he discovers God's love. When we listen, we become not only Christ for each other, but we also create the holy ground in which we find God in both the speaking and the listening, the unburdening and the caring presence. When I first read that poem that I read earlier, it brought to my mind a TED Talk that I had seen years ago, that maybe many of you have also seen. It's called The Danger of a Single Story. The speaker recounts moving from Africa to attend college in the United States. Her roommate makes several assumptions about her based on the fact that she's from Africa. And all of these assumptions turn out to not be true. The speaker calls this the danger of a single story. You see, her roommate had only heard one story about people from Africa, that they were very poor and starved and uneducated, when in fact this speaker was quite the opposite. She had to teach her roommate about how different her life had been from the assumptions she had made. And that's why it is important to hear someone's perspective without jumping to our own conclusions or assumptions. And we know conversations like these happen every single day. I have a piece of artwork for you to see. It is entitled, Love is a Listening Ear. It's by Stephanie Hawk. And we can see how such a conversation is occurring. We see what appears to be two women engaged in deep conversation over a meal at a restaurant. I can imagine them taking turns recounting events that are happening in each other's lives. One will talk while the other listens, and then they swap and repeat. Where we can find ourselves getting into trouble is when we are listening and we are already plotting our reply. We're not truly listening, are we? There's a danger in the missing the message. If we focus solely on what we're going to respond with and not what is actually being said. You know, I see in this image, this meal, and it reminds me of this table and where Christ meets us in a similar meal at this table. And he shares who he is with us. He comes as the fully embodied ear, so to speak, listening intently to everything that's on our hearts. And we unburden ourselves as we approach the table, only then to be filled with his presence. Christ knows what it's like to be bombarded with the sounds of the world. Even he knew to remove himself into silent retreat and prayer, which is exactly what nights like tonight are all about. So continue to breathe as we listen to another beautiful piece of music.
It's real.
as we begin to close our time together tonight, we pray to a God who hears us when we speak and knows the words that are on our hearts. Let us pray together. Listening God, we know you hear everything we say. We know you listen intently to us, who so often ignore you in our daily lives. We ask that you would take what is closed inside us and find a way to open it up. Find what is distracted in us and help us to settle it down. And take what is hurting inside us and hold it and hold us. Take any part of us that creates distance from you. Take it away. We know we sometimes argue about things we know nothing about. And we fear things that we cannot see. And we almost always speak more often than we listen. So we ask you to open us, to settle us, to hold us, and forgive us. We long to hear you more clearly. We long to know you more fully. With hope we pray, and with gratitude we confess. Amen. We are so grateful for your presence this evening. And we hope that this has been the midweek bump that your week has needed. Just a few moments to settle your soul as you go about the rest of your week. Continue this art form called listening. Practice it with the loved ones around you. You will notice an immediate difference if you do. You can start practicing right now. Stay on the service just a few more moments and enjoy the sounds of the music. It's good to see you all. Good night.